Welcome, everybody, to another exciting broadcast of SummitCitySports.com Boys High School Basketball. We have an unbelievable Class 2A matchup for you today. The Bowman Academy Eagles, 7-7 on the season, to take on the Bishop Luers Knights, 7-5. Folks, these are two of Class 2A's premier schools, with the Bowman Academy finishing as the state runner-ups last year and the state champs in 2010. I'm not 100% sure on this, but this is just the fifth or sixth year of the school. And they come from the Gary area up in the region, Northwest Indiana. In 2010, Bowman and Coach Marvin Ray had a 17-9 record, and folks, they played tough competition. In that year, they started off playing Chicago Farragut, lost that one 65-56, Chicago Curry, and then North Central out of Indianapolis, their first three opponents. They're a 2A school, but they play big-time competition. Coach Marvin Ray won state that year in 2010 when they beat Bar Reeve 74-52. And folks, excuse me, but in 2010, they had a 24-1 record. Those three games I was referring to were in the 2012 season. That's when Bowman, with a 17-9 record, made it all the way to state before losing to Park Tudor 79-57. Indiana fans will know Park Tudor. That's where Yogi Farrell played his high school ball. And that's where another big-time recruit in Trayvon Blewett. Blewett is a junior and actually plays AAU ball with James Blackman Jr. for the Bishop Luers Knights. Let's talk about the Knights for a little bit, coming off a tough loss at Northside last night. The Knights losing it to the Redskins 85-76. James Blackman Jr. leading all scorers with 27 points. His brother VJ Blackman had 20 points. Also for the Knights, it was number three, Tyrell Johnson, chipping in 10 points. Solomon Smith had 5. Austin Mack chipped in 4. Austin Rybicki had 2. CJ McCarter was 6. And Tony Shelton had 2 points. For the Redskins, Sean McGee had 10. Mitchell had 21. Mike Davis, 19. Jeremy Jones, 5. Dwight Richards, 17. Nigel Jones, 2. And Travion Cruz had 11 points to lead the Northside Redskins. Bishop Luers this year, once again, a 7-5 overall record. Tough loss at Mishawaka Marion to start the season. Mishawaka Marion, of course, boasts point guard Demetrius Jackson heading to Notre Dame next year to play for Mike Bray. He'll also be joined by VJ Beecham, New Haven's own VJ Beecham. Folks, big time matchup this Saturday when VJ Beecham and the North or the New Haven Bulldogs take on Homestead for the NHC, what appears to be the NHC championship crown. Big time game right there for both schools. Also for Luers, taking a loss 77-68 at Concordia. They beat Southside 79-63. Took on Indianapolis Chatard and won that one 65-62. Lost against Snyder 101-87. That was the opening round of the SAC Holiday Tournament. Beat Dwenger 68-61. Beat Muncie South 79-73. And then Luers lost 3 of their players heading into a game against the Northrop Bruins. Northrop getting the better of the Knights in that one, 95-59. Bishop Luers went on to rattle off 3 straight W's against Fort Wayne Blackhawk, 81-73, Fort Wayne Wayne, 64-55, and Muncie Burris, 76-59, before last night's loss to Northside, last night's loss took Bishop Luers out of SAC. Well, it took their hopes away for an SAC title. Northside with the win, tied in second place with Concordia. Both schools with 4-2 conference records. Northrop with the big win against Southside, sitting atop the SAC with a 5-1 record. But hold on, Northrop has to travel to Concordia. And if the Concordia Cadets were to get the upset victory on their home court, then it would be Northside that would be the SAC champions. That's right, the Redskins have beat both Northrop on their own floor and Concordia at the basement over there in Concordia. Their SAC losses came to Snyder. Other SAC loss for Northside escapes me right now. Oh, they lost to Wayne in overtime. And if you want to see that game or watch highlights for the game, just check it out on our website, SummitCitySports.com. Folks, you can also join, like our Facebook page, Summit City Sports, and follow us on Twitter, 260Sports. Also, of course, James Blackman Jr. heading to IU next year to play for Tom Crean. And VJ Blackman, his brother, a true freshman. This is high school, so I should just say freshman. But VJ, 20-point performance last night. He, too, has been offered by IU. And when we look on the other side of the court at the Bowman Academy Eagles, well, they got a player, too, that IU is looking at. His name is Devon Dillard, a sophomore, number 24, 6'4" forward, averaging 14 points per game and 8 rebounds. Folks, everybody's looking at the sensational sophomore, Mr. Dillard. North Carolina's been in contact. IU, Purdue, Michigan State, you name it, they've been knocking on his door. A couple other names to look out for. It's junior number 2, Arthur Haggard III, averaging 13 points per game, 2 rebounds, and 3 assists. Northern Illinois and Utah State looking at Mr. Haggard. Number 10 is Deshaun Franklin. He's a junior, 6'1 forward, 3 points, 3 rebounds a game. Number 15, Antonio Pipkin, a senior at 6'3". He's a forward. Antonio Pipkin scored 31 points in a game this year, and that is a school record. He can light it up when he gets hot from the field. He averages 11 points per game and 7 rebounds. Oh, yeah, and Antonio Pipkin? Yeah, he's a 6'3" quarterback on the football team. Very impressive arm, I am told, for Mr. Antonio Pipkin. He's looking to play football next year, and Northern Illinois has interest. He's also looking at Division III Wabash here in the state of Indiana. Number 22 is Justin King, averages 12 points per game and 7 rebounds. He's a junior, 6'7" forward. We already told you about Devon Dillard. Folks, this is the Bowman Academy Eagles. And before you say, Bowman who? Like I said, they're in their 5th to 6th year of the school's existence. They are legit with a state title already under their belt in 2010. A state runner-up finish last year. Well, it was just 2 games ago on January the 19th, 7 days ago, when the Bowman Academy Eagles hosted the Northrop Bruins. Yeah, Bowman got the 74-73 victory over Bryson and Brenton Scott. Folks, we're going to send it down on the floor real quick for a few announcements.
In order to promote good sportsmanship, ethics, and integrity in high school athletics, Bishop Luers High School asks you to participate in positive support of your own team without negative effects directed toward your opponent, the fans, other schools, or the officials. Your cooperation and example to those around you is greatly appreciated. Please stand and remove your caps for the national anthem.
2 minutes and 20 seconds on the game clock here for today's big matchup. Once again, James Blackman Jr. heading to IU. He is a verbal commit, a junior for the Bishop Luers Knights. Actually committed with Trey Lyles from Indianapolis Tech. You know, Bowman Academy, they opened up the season at Indianapolis Tech, which is a Class 4A team. Indianapolis Tech getting the 69-56 victory over Bowman Academy. You talk about the Eagles, they've got a 7-7 record. Let's just look at their first four games, all four losses. At Indiana Tech, they hosted Hamilton Southeastern, lost 73-71. At Andrean, a Class 3A school, lost 73-68. At North Central in Indianapolis, Class 4A school, lost that 84-63. Rattled off two victories against Chicago Hyde Park, 81-76. And Brownsburg, Class 4A school, 59-55. Went on to lose three more games. Evansville North, Ben Davis, and Lawrence Central. Closest game there was against Lawrence Central, the 74-72 loss. Since then, though, has won five straight. At Lake Station, Horizon Christian, Hales Franciscan, Fort Wayne Northrop, and Traders Point Christian. So Bowman Academy, 7-7 record, but they have not played very many slouches. This is a tough team. They're battle-tested, it appears, from the looks of their schedule. Bishop Luers Knights, boy, ever since they lost those three players, not to mention the fact Jalen Smith, of course, not playing this year, but now the team is starting to learn to play together with a new group of players. We'll send it down the floor now for starting lineups. All set here, 8 minutes on the clock, first quarter, getting ready to start. You heard the starters over there for the Bowman Academy, number 15, that's Antonio Pipkin in the center there. Big man, number 24, Devon Dillard, the super sophomore. He's going to jump against number 24, freshman VJ Blackman. Right behind VJ is number 2, James Blackman, and number 2, Arthur Haggard III for Bowman Academy. Possession goes to Bowman. That's Haggard that controls it. Lob City right away. Big time dunk by number 24, Devon Dillard. Bowman comes out in the press. James Blackman right away breaks it. Pass went over to number 34. That's Austin Mack. Turnover by the Knights. What a way to start this game by Bowman. Watching the JV game, Bowman won that one 51-24. They're an exciting team to watch. On the baseline, that was Pipkin. Got it back out to Dillard. 4-3, Devon Dillard. What a way to start this game. Big time dunk and a three-pointer. 5-0. And Antonio Pipkin with a tight D there on V.J. Blackman. So James is going to inbound here. Gets it over to number three for the Knights. Tyrell Johnson. B.J. out of the corner. Gets it over to Arthur Mack. Good feed underneath to C.J. McCarter. And James Blackman Jr. gets it up and in. He'll head to the line for one. James Blackman Jr., a savvy basketball player as you're going to find in this state. The junior once again committing before his freshman year, right at the start of his freshman year for Bishop Luers. Connects there. He's got a pretty, pretty free throw shot, that's for sure. Bowman off and running once again. Number 10 out to number 2 for 3. Haggard the third, rebounded by C.J. McCarter. James Blackman now, quick move, gets tripped up. Loose balls picked up by Pipkin. Pipkin going hard. He gets fouled, blocking called on number 3, Tyrell Johnson. Forgive me, folks, but number 10 for Bowman Academy, Deshaun Franklin. Pipkin's first free throw is up and in. The senior, 6'3", quarterback on the football team, reportedly has a cannon off the heel, rebounded by Mack. BJ now lob pass over to James. James picks it out of the air. Feed by Tyrell Johnson was stolen by Haggard the third. Johnson tracks down the ball. Tip pass goes over to James Blackman, who's double teamed. They're keeping a close eye on him. Arthur Mack underneath. Excuse me, Austin Mack. Wow. Another big time dunk there. Johnson gives that one up to Pipkin, and Pipkin finishes. So 10-5 right now. Off the mark. Austin Mack trying to come down with it. A rebound was by Haggard the third over the back. Looks like the foul's going to go on number 34, Mack. Heading to the line will be number 24, Devon Dillard. Dillard to shoot two. 5:51 on the game clock. Hits them both. So 12-5 right now. Another forced turnover. Pipkin underneath. McCarter with the defense. Perimeter ball movement. Three-point shot was taken by number 22, Justin King, averaging 12 points per game. Lob goes over to James Blackman. Couldn't finish. Save goes right to Trell Johnson. CJ has it stolen. Devon Dillard going the other way, and he turns it over. Once again, Devon Dillard, a sophomore, 14 points per game, 8 rebounds, 6'4". North Carolina's called Michigan State, IU, and Purdue for the sophomore. Tyrell Johnson picks that ball out of the air with his left hand. Turnover picked up by Pipkin. Pipkin driving hard. Does not finish, but gets his own rebound. McCarter underneath with the defense. Pipkin gets it in. Carter picks up his dribble. Luers having a hard time just getting on the offensive end. Three-pointer by Blackman Jr. off the mark. Number 22 is Solomon Smith into the game for the Knights. Well, pretty much what we expected, up and down. Give me my third event of the day. I'm having a hard time keeping up, but these kids can play. A lot of fun here at Bishop Luers. Entering for Bowman Academy is number 33. Montrell Bearfield. He actually played three-pointer up and in by number 24,
BJ.
14-8, 4:40 on the clock. BJ Waldoff, suffocating press here by Bowman early on. James Blackman Jr. calls the timeout. So already in this game, Bowman Academy coming out with a 5-0 lead. Luers tied it up. Well, got as close as 5-7. Two big dunks already by number 24, Devon Dillard. Also a three-point for the Super Soft. Blackman takes the feed. This press has been suffocating all game, and we are not even 4 minutes in. Johnson Tyrell is sprinting to the bucket there. A little out of control, and that tip ball is going to stay in the direction of Bowman Academy. Each team, two fouls apiece. 4:13 on the clock. Loose ball, looks like it was kicked out of bounds. Turnover by Bowman. That's Arthur Haggard, third. Junior at 6'3". Johnson over to James. James, one touch to BJ. BJ finding some separation. A little floater in the lane is good. BJ Blackman now back-to-back buckets here for the Knights. Pulling Bishop Luers within six. Working from the corner, that's number 34, Anthony Cole. Fadeaway jumper, up and in by number 22, Justin King. Tyrell Johnson, outlet pass, number 52, jumper. It's a little bit off the mark. That's Tony Shelton. Shelton getting the scoring action last night against Northside. Number 34 is Anthony Cole. Three-point attempt. Rattles in and out by Haggard the third. Rebounded by Shelton. Looks like James going to draw the foul. Foul's going to be called on Haggard the third. That's his first and the team's third. Back into the lineup, it's number 15, Pipkin, and number 24, Devon Dillard. Both of those two already. Nice start to this game. James with the inbounds, gets it up to Johnson. BJ back to James. James has four Eagles converge on him from the hip, was no good. Rebound, and it looks like we got a tie up on the floor. That's Solomon Smith. Another timeout call by James Blackman, 32nd. 2:57 left to play here in the first quarter. Eagles up by eight. Really just suffocating defense so far. Luers doing everything they can just to get a little bit of separation. James Blackman Jr. started the scoring off for Bishop Luers. Got the lay-in and one. Hit his free throw as he so commonly does. Very smooth free throw shooter. Number 34 was Austin Mack. Got a lay-in underneath. And last two buckets, a three-pointer and a lay-in by VJ Blackman. Your 10 points for Bishop Luers. James with the inbounds, gets it over to his brother. Once again, double team right away. Nice. VJ heads-up play there, throwing it off the foot of Mr. Dillard. Found himself in a corner. Head coach James Blackman's already called two timeouts to get his team out of those situations. So nice heads-up play by BJ. James trying to go behind the back, but, man, every time he tries to do anything, he's got at least three Eagles around him. Three-pointers up and off the mark. Rebounded by Shelton. Putback no good. Dillard comes down with it. Working the ball. Pipkin with the lay-in. That ball is knocked out of bounds by number 33, Montrell Fairfield. Unlike really anything I've seen this year, this Bowman Academy defense. And nice putback by Tony Shelton. Devon Dillard in the lane, pulls up off the mark. Knights down by 8, 20-12. James Blackman silk smooth in the lane. For James, that is his fifth point of the game. Turn around in the lane. And we got travel going to be called by number 22, Justin King. Two new members for Bowman into the game. It's number 2, Haggard the third. Number 10 is Deshaun Franklin. Bowman Academy, they go pretty deep here on the bench. BJ threw it back to Tyrell Johnson before he really saw what was happening, and we got another turnover, this time Anthony Cole with the travel. Johnson once again with the inbounds. Really nowhere to go with it. Luers has got to move. James working his tail off just to get free. Tyrell all the way down to... That's number 22, Solomon Smith. Foul's going to be called on Pipkin. Reach in from behind. Yeah, so far this is a kind of cardiac game here. Folks, up and down. Once again, it's number 3, Tyrell Johnson, a 6'4" sophomore guard with the inbounds. That's stolen by Haggard the third. Gives it over to Devon Dillard. Throwing it down big time. No doubt about that one. Easy two. Shelton gets it over to BJ now. BJ finds a wide open James Blackman for three. Pretty looking shot there by Mr. Blackman Jr. 22-17, 1:13 on the clock. Lane was no good. James once again pulling up from the wing off the front of the iron. BJ picks it up, shoots it from three, in and out. Tyrell Johnson nearly knocked that one away from Haggard the third. Franklin pulls up, stops on a dime. Devon Dillard now for three, and he hits it with James Blackman right in his face. That's his second three-pointer of the game. 25-17, and Dillard knocks that one into the third row of the bleachers. Wow. Devon Dillard, you can see why every major school, every major Division I program in this country is after number 24. 6'4" sophomore. 2 3-pointers already, 3 monster dunks. Looking like Sean Kemp back in the 80s throwing it down here at Bishop Luers. B.J. Blackman with the turnover on the other end. Oh, nearly a big block there by James Blackman. He falls hard on his hip. We got an official timeout. Trying to keep a game log here, and I swear I cannot take my eyes off the court for 2 seconds. That's how fast Bowman Academy is at putting the points in the bucket. Looks like Austin Mack's going to re-enter. Give James Blackman just a little bit of a breather there. Fell hard on his hip. Looks to be okay. He's shaking off. Remember James Blackman last year after, I believe it was 18 games, suffering an ACL injury. So not really at 100% right now. C.J. McCarter, Tyrell Johnson, B.J. Over to C.J. CJ looking to go off the glass, gets his own rebound. Putback is up and in. He'll head to the line for the and one. CJ his first 2 points of the game. Converts it, keeping the Knights within seven. Number 35 is into the game now. That's Tashawn Lanier. Antonio Pipkin to take a breather, sitting right next to Devon Dillard on the bench. Right at the buzzer, hitting it. It's Tashawn Franklin. So at the end of one, 29-20, Bowman Academy on top. Lots of scoring here in this game. James Blackman Jr. for the Knights with 8 points. On the other side, you got to look at Devon Dillard, opened up with a monster dunk. All of his dunks have been monster dunks, but 2 points there. Followed that up with a three-pointer. Leads all scorers with 14 points. Obviously, we have no live stats right now from the Bishop Luers. Don't normally get those in high school. Normally reserved for the college game, but I've got to say, Devon Dillard, I'm not sure if he's missed a shot yet. Sweet, sweet stroke from beyond the arc and having no problem finishing hard at the bucket with the big slams. James Blackman is going to stay on the bench here to start the second. Fell hard going up for that block. Got a piece of the block, but the dunk still went down, and I believe that was number 10 with the dunk, Tashawn Franklin. But I'm going to have to double-check that one in the scorer's book at halftime for you. That pass is stolen. It's number 35 with the lay-in, Tashawn Lanier. CJ LeCard, Tyrell Johnson, Bowman Academy in the press the whole game, and they're able to stay in the press. CJ finishing hard, but the charge is going to be called on the big man. 31-20, 21 seconds here into the second. Bowman Academy playing two lineups so far. They go deep on the bench. Haggard, cross-court pass goes over to Lanier. James Blackman Jr. to check back in. Hat called on number 3, Tyrell Johnson. That's his second foul. The team's fourth at the line is Tashawn Franklin to shoot two. First one's up and in with a swish. So James checks back in for Johnson. Second free throw attempt. It's good as well. Largest lead of the game for Bowman Academy right now. 13 points, 33-20. 7:29 left to play here in the second. At the end of one, remember, it was 29-20. Bishop Luers, as that ball is kicked out of bounds by Demario Smith. BJ over to CJ. CJ picks it out of the air with his right. This over Shelton back to BJ. Looking for James. That was tipped by Franklin. James picks it up, but already has two Eagles all over him. BJ, nice feed to Austin Mack. Big block there by number 22, Justin King. Points are not easy to come by here against the Bowman Academy Eagles here in the second quarter and throughout this game. BJ with the inbounds pass. 7:06 on the clock. Goes up high to Austin Mack. Knocking it away is number 25, Demario Smith, the junior. Nice feed to Franklin. Floater in the lane, rebounded by number 52, Tony Shelton. James Blackman looking for Shelton, a little bit long. Max saves it, out of bounds, turnover by the Knights. Once again, if you were to look at some of the previews from our great media here in Fort Wayne, Indiana, the News Sentinel, the Journal-Gazette, a lot of the guys that were in the preview for Bishop Luers aren't members of this team anymore. James Blackman Jr., a tough assignment here, playing with a lot of guys he didn't even think he was going to really be playing with, possibly back in August. Long three-point attempt by DeMario Smith. Wow. When it rains, it pours. DeMario Smith throwing that one up from about 25 feet. The Eagles coming out here. 7-0 run to start the second. 9-0 run in total in the game log. Got passed on by Haggard the third. Showtime. Shelton going after the loose ball. Wow. Haggard the third diving after it. Like they're down by 18 points. And the Bowman Academy, Eagle fans up on their feet. Brought a big charter bus here. A lot of support here for their beloved Eagles. Once again, it's a newer school in the region. Gary, Indiana, in existence. It's either 5 or 6 years. Not 100% sure on that one. And a missed dunk by number 35, to Sean Lanier. Looked like that one was going to be a can of corn. Was not to be. So James Blackman over to his brother. Back to James. BJ picked off that pass. That was kind of like a pinball effect there for a second. And driving in the lane, travels called before the jump ball could be. Tying him up was number 22, Justin King. 12 points per game, 7 rebounds, a 6'7" forward. Justin is a junior. Some of the schools looking at Justin King. You got Northern Illinois, Iowa, DePaul, and Valparaiso. Lots of highly touted recruits on this team. That's number 35 with the lay-in. Sean Lanier missed the dunk earlier, made up for it right there. Stepping on the sideline there was DeMario Smith. On camera today is Garrett Harvey, a new intern with me. Garrett plays football for the University of St. Francis Cougars. C.J. McCarter, stop pops. Rebound was by Lanier. Smith gets it over to number 11, Lyndon Jackson. First time we've called his name all game. Also in, that was Rubicki. Nice defense there by the big man, number 40. Austin Rubicki, 6'4" junior. James, foul on the arm. He's going to head to line for two. James with 8 points there in the first quarter. A perfect 2-for-2 from the free throw line. Both of those. No, excuse me, 1-for-1. James also had a 3-pointer. 2-for-2, just like I said. Coming in now is number 33, Montrell Bearfield. He's a part of PSY, Sports Youth Foundation, AAU team. A lot of these guys also play for Mean Streets. As James connects on both of them, breaking the 11-0 run by Bowman Academy. Score is 40-22. In transition, BJ Blackman with a beautiful lay-in. The freshman, number 24. BJ Blackman getting Luers their 24th point. And already on the other end with the lay-in was number 10, Deshaun Franklin. Tyrell Johnson. Coach Blackman's already called two timeouts because of this press that Bowman Academy likes to play with. Remember, this is a team that beat Northrop by two Northrop, a veteran squad there with Scott Twins. Three-point attempt up off the front of the iron. Rebounded by Tyrell Johnson. That was Lyndon Jackson with the three-point attempt. Tyrell now top of the key, feeds it down to C.J. McCarter. Tough off the glass. Mr. McCarter, sophomore, 6 foot, the big man. Forty to 26, Luers with six straight points here. Fadeaway jumper, up and in. So smooth, Justin King. B.J. Blackman nearly had that knocked away. Nice little move there, V.J. Getting her done at the bucket. 28-42, 2:56 left. Foul's going to go on number two, James Blackman. Push. Heading the line for two is number 22, King. So the first attempt, no good. 44-28, 2:56 left to play here. Second one's good. So 45-28. James looking for the inbounds. It hasn't been easy all game. Looks like a foul's going to be called on number 34. Hold. That's his first and the team's seventh. Once again, Bowman Academy subbing in and out routinely. Seventh foul, so VJ will shoot the bonus here. Front end coming up. Off the back of the iron. From this spectator's viewpoint, hard to believe Bowman Academy's lost seven games this year, but once again, they play tough, tough competition. Opened up with Indiana Tech, that's Trey Lyles. Trey and James are good buddies playing on the Speece Indy Heat team. BJ hits both of them. Pull Luers within 15. Foul this time is going to be called, it looks like, on number 24, Devon Diller. Sophomore, 6'4". Trying to decide here. Devon Dillard, who I could really compare him to in the NBA. Muscle set at 6'4". Can jump out of the gym. Could kind of say Vince Carter, but got a little bit wider of a build than Vince, but his athleticism's out of this world and hitting that tray frequently with ease. His last one came with James Blackman right in his face. Coming down with the board on the James Blackman miss was Lanier. Going the other way with it. Haggard the third. Putback's no good. Rubicki with the rebound. Austin Rubicki proven to be a valuable member to Luers here in this game. Whoa, big collision Tyrell Johnson took from Tashawn Lanier, the junior, 6 foot forward. That's just how Bowman Academy plays. 100 and, I would say 10, but it's more like 145 miles an hour. Up and down, logging the game here. It's like you almost can't take your eyes off the court. You're going to miss something. I have missed two scores for Bowman. My apologies. First free throw is up and in off the back of the glass. Johnson getting his first points of the second quarter here. His first points of the game. Tyrell hitting them both. 45-32 now. The Knights within 13. Back, 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 back. James Blackman with the defense. That's Mr. Dillard getting over to Lanier. Turnover by the Eagles. Justin King could not handle that pass. There's big Rubicki. Austin Rubicki, a big body in there, able to provide some spark on the defensive end for the Knights. Shot was just off the mark. We got another travel there. A little dance step there in the lane. It was pretty, but it was not legal. So Lanier is going to head to the bench, and into the lineup is number 25, DeMario Smith. VJ over to James Blackman. James, every time James touches the ball, he's got three Eagles draped all over him. Looks like we got a foul call on CJ McCarter. In the lane there was Justin King. When I first saw Justin King's name, I thought of the Fab Five, early 90s Michigan. And certainly Bowman Academy somewhat resembles the talent that Michigan fivesome had. First one's in by King. 46-32. Second one's good as well. Back to a 15-point advantage here for the Eagles. James finding wide open Tyrell Johnson. Beautiful feed to Rubicki. Turnover right off his knee. And folks, you see it a lot. I do the play-by-play for University of St. Francis women's basketball. One of the best teams in the country right now at number six. Raised up three spots after beating the number one team in the country, Indiana Wesleyan. They own that game. Feed down low. Number 11 off the glass is Lyndon Jackson. But my point being, they play the same type of suffocating defense, and you can see it really wear on the team. Beautiful drive in the lane by James Blackman. And a blocking foul. Looked like Rubicki had his feet set. I was ready to call the charge, but like I said, Austin Rubicki didn't play a whole lot in last night's game, the loss to Northside. But in this game right here, really proving to be a very valuable player for the Knights. Rubicki, number 40, is a 6'4" junior, plays center for the Knights. That's one thing the Bowman Academy really doesn't have, is a big wide body like that. King hits his first. He's been money from the free throw line here in the second. King is 4 for 5, looking to make it 5 for 6. Got it. 51-34, 1:10 left to play here in the second. Tyrell Johnson, BJ, over to James. James pulling up from the wing. Stop, pop off the back of the iron. James Blackman, Jr. Another three-pointer for the Indiana Verbal. Three-point up this time by number 11, Lyndon Jackson answers. Tyrell over to BJ. BJ to James. James got a little bit of room to roam. Quickly gets it over back to Tyrell. That's kind of what you have to do here, those one-touch passes. Haggard the third, knocked it away from BJ. Lob went over to Devon Dillard, the rim rocker, number 24. He's provided quite a highlight reel here so far, folks. I believe that's his fourth dunk. I will double check my stats here at the break. Three-point attempt by Johnson, no good. CJ McCarter coming down with the rebound. Now the floater in the lane's up and in. Nice work by CJ. Having a nice game is Miss Nakata. McCarter, I should say. Hiller the third, shot was off the mark. Tyrell Johnson came down with the rebound. Knights could not get the last shot off. Whistles blow like there might be point something seconds left on the clock, but both teams head into halftime. Folks, we're going to take a little bit of a break here, see about getting some point totals for you, maybe some updates from the Twitter, and we will be back. Thank you.
Oh, scoring highs? Fifteen for James Blackman Jr. 16. You got him for 18?
Yeah, probably.
Folks, we have 1 minute and 12 seconds left on the clock here before the start of the third. 56-39. Bowman Academy on top. Bowman Academy is coached by Mr. Marvin Ray, 86-39 in his sixth year at the school. So this is the sixth year of the school's existence. Of course, James Blackman Sr. in his ninth season here at Bishop Luers, 138-61 record. Folks, once again, this is what I pulled off the newspaper. Returning starters and regulars for Bishop Luers: James Blackman Jr., Jalen Smith, Michael Rogers, Kendrick Mullen, Matt Harris, Braxton Randolph. None of those guys are on the roster right now. Key newcomers: Brandon Jackson, 6'5" senior forward, not on the roster. B.J. Blackman, the other newcomer. Tells you a little bit of what Coach James Blackman Sr. and James Blackman Jr. have had to deal with this year. Almost reminds me of that transitional period when Shaq left the Lakers and Kobe was kind of left there, I don't want to say fending for himself, because, wow, we've had some great performances by C.J. McCarter in this game. V.J. Blackman, the freshman, Tyrell Johnson, just breaking the press in itself in this game has been quite an accomplishment. Bowman Academy's deep, folks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 folks scoring for the Eagles. Game high, 18 points by number 24, Devon Dillard. He's got the ball right now. Nice feed down low. Kick back out to number 22, Justin King. King hit a bunch of free throws there in the second quarter. He has 9 points. Blackman Jr., reverse lay-in. All the way at the other end. Nice move there. That's the QB, number 15, Antonio Pipkin. Blackman once again falling hard. This game, Bowman Academy, they're up and down the court at probably 172 miles an hour. We've already seen some huge collisions down there on the floor. They sub in and out almost about every 2 minutes, it seems like. Already another new member about to go into the game, number 34 for the Eagles. Shot was rebounded by number 10, Haggard III. Starting lineup on the floor for Bowman. Turnover by the Eagles. There's one thing that you can get them to do. The Eagles have been, I don't want to say turnover prone, but they have shown to turn the ball over, and that kind of goes with this frantic pace that they play at. It's nothing like anything I've seen in Fort Wayne, that's for sure. VJ, nice job by Terrell Johnson. Getting that ball, and CJ McCarter underneath, getting the bucket. 58-43. VJ knocks that ball away from Devon Dillard. VJ a freshman, Dillard a sophomore. He goes down low. Haggard III, travel going to be called. Had a bunch of travels. That might be the fourth or fifth called on the Eagles in this game. VJ nearly had that one stolen. You have to be on your guard at all time against this Eagle team. I mean, they are high flyers. They are up and down the court very fast. Now Luers starting to pick up the D a little bit. Good ball movement. Devon Dillard, baseline jumper. That might be his first miss of the game. BJ comes up with the ball. Four monster dunks by Dillard in the first half. Two trays. Beautiful looking trays. One with James Blackburn right in his face. It's great defense. That one is rebounded by Dillard. Got to slap that pass over to number 34, Anthony Cole. Justin King down low. Dillard the dunker. 60-43. Inside 6 minutes to play. Steal by Haggard III. In the lane. James Blackman over Shelton. VJ over Johnson. James pump fake. Lay-in. Beautiful lay-in by Mr. James Blackman. Your leading scorer for the night. He now has 19 points in this game. Elbow jumper by Deshaun Franklin was no good. Looked like a little foul there. Three-pointer up by James. Rebounded by number 34, Cole. And going the other way with it, Haggard III. Now they're going to call the foul on Johnson. For number three, I believe that's his third foul of the game. Austin Rubicki to re-enter along with number 22, Solomon Smith. VJ and James going to take a breather here. Rubicki playing some very valuable minutes there in the first half. A big wide body underneath. Hard for Bowman Academy to deal with. If there's one thing they don't have, it's the big frames like CJ McCarter and Austin Rubicki. Rebounded by Tyrell Johnson. Johnson gets it up to Rubicki. He has it knocked away from behind by number 10. The foul's going to be called to Sean Franklin. Actually, the foul goes on number 22, Justin King. For King, that's his second, the team's second. Rubicki at the line to shoot two. First free throw attempt is up and in by Rubicki. Second one's good as well. 62-47, Knights within 15. That's pretty much been the case ever since the start of the third or second quarter. Excuse me. Nice steal by Terrell Johnson. Pulls up just inside the arc. Rattles out. King comes down with the board. Smith gets back on defense. Man, these one-touch passes. Bowman Academy, for a team that goes up and down, they also do a great job in the half court, and that is what you get with this team. They're so fast. I saw a little kid walking along the sidelines earlier and was a little bit scared. Almost seems like the court's not big enough. King's going to head to the bench. Back in the lineups, number 25, DeMario Smith. Rubicki over to Johnson. Cross court Shelton. Shelton's camped out in the corner. Solomon Smith finds Johnson driving baseline, going hard. Smith with a putback, and he'll be fouled heading the line. Solomon Smith is a 6'4" sophomore center. Some nice youth here for the Bishop Luers Knights. But you had a guy like Jalen Smith, who obviously is not playing this year because he's getting ready for his upcoming season with the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. Jalen, Mr. Football in the state of Indiana. First ever from Northeast Indiana. I do believe I read that earlier this year. Hard to believe when you figure Rod Woodson and Vaughn Dunbar, some of the great football players that have came out of this area. Rubicki comes down with the board hard. Big country down there. Solomon Smith now. Big time block, and they're going to call the foul on Solomon. And a little bit of frustration coming out there because every time you have the ball, you got a couple of Eagles all the way around you. BJ's going to head back in for Bishop Luers. Looks like James might stay on the bench for a little bit because he's hit the ground hard a couple of times. And as we said, coming off the ACL from last year, coach is going to let him sit for just a second. Oh, just as I speak, James and BJ back in. James playing it cool, sitting there till the very last second. Once he found out he could go in, bam, off the bench. Making that first free throw was Anthony Cole, number 34. In the first half, Anthony had 2 points. 3 on the game. Rubicki comes down with the rebound. James is passed. James comes up with a block. Foul is going to be called on Blackman Jr. Heading back to the line is Cole. Number 34, Anthony Cole. Cole now's missed his last 2 free throws. 63-48. It's the second. 64 now. Lead up to 16. BJ looking to split defenders. Foul's going to be called this time on number 25, DeMario Smith. I talk about it all the time. If you don't practice against this kind of speed, it's almost nearly impossible to simulate in practice. And it's an eye-opener when it's right in front of you. Baseline jumper a little bit hard by Shelton, rebounded by Devon Dillard. Cross-court pass goes to number 11, Jackson Drayton. 67-48. Lyndon Jackson's a senior, 6 foot. Lands good there by DeMario Smith. Eagles can score in bunches with that defense. That time picking up the loose ball was Haggard the third. Nearly had 7 consecutive points. Bang, 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 just like that. Currently, the Eagles are on a 7-0 run. Arthur Haggard III at the line to shoot 2 off the front of the iron. Second one's good. So the lead is extended to 22 points. Timeout called. Just blues. Full timeout. Once again, currently an 8-0 run by Bowman Academy. Luers Got back into it for a second there. James Blackman Jr. with a lay-in. And then four straight made field goals or free throws, two by Austin Rubicki and two by Solomon Smith. Since then, it's been all Bowman Academy, and not to mention the fact that a three-pointer, steal and a lay-in, steal and almost another lay-in, and Haggard III hit the second free throw. So just like that, 6 points in a matter of, I don't know, maybe 12 seconds. 3:02 left on the clock here in the third quarter. Score is 70-48. Coach James Blackman Sr. really doing a good job with this team. We talked about it earlier. The loss against Northrop was 95-59. Of course, Northrop lost to Bowman Academy by two. But right before that game, Luers lost three key members of this team. Almost doesn't seem fair, but such is life. Loose ball picked up by Sheldon. Now in transition, James Blackman Jr. going hard with the dunk. James throwing it right down in the face of Devon Dillard. Wow. James Blackman Jr. rising to the occasion. Rubicki with the rebound. Wow. 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 CJ McCarter looking for the putback. Dillard comes down with the board. Dillard earlier in this game hit a three-pointer with James Blackman right in his face. I think we got a foul going to be called on number 34 this time. Cole. Let's see. But something about that dunk right there, it's almost like James just rose to a whole nother level. You can see the frustration. I mean, this guy's got a heart of a champion, like very similar to Kobe Bryant. I know I mentioned that correlation earlier. Nice feed to Austin Rubicki underneath for two. So a 4-0 run right now. It's 70-52, 28-point lead by the Eagles. Good ball movement. Devon Dillard, two-handed. Devon Dillard just given that stare. He just simply knows he's better than everybody else. Devon Dillard. Well, Roy Williams has been like a kind of game film on Devon Dillard. Same with Tom Crean, Painter, Tom Izzo. They all like this young man's game. Nothing wrong with James Blackman Jr.'s game either. James Blackman just showed his upside a moment ago. Folks, you'll have to just check out SummitCitySports.com for that highlight. I might just cut a highlight of all dunks and three-pointers, because they've been pretty sweet in this game. Dillard this time blocked by Shelton. These two teams are getting into it, man. Luers has really kind of stepped up here in the second half. Look at the scoring in the first quarter. Bowman Academy 29-20, 27-19 in the second quarter. BJ walled off by Shelton from the corner. James Blackman off the iron. Putback's no good. James going in hard. And I think the foul's going to go on number 20, on number two. Luers really now just starting to kind of match the game by Bowman. Kind of fighting fire with fire here. Really showing some intensity I haven't seen out of the Knights yet this year. Three-point attempt off the heel. Rebounded by C.J. McCarter. C.J.'s had a great game. Feed goes over to V.J. V.J. looking for the reverse. Knocked out of bounds by Haggard III. V.J. was forced a little bit too far underneath the bucket there. The chant is, you got swatted, but really there was no need for it. The lay-in hit kind of the bottom of the backboard as Haggard III just muscled it out of bounds. Long three-pointer by James Blackman Jr. JBJ getting it done from beyond the arc. 73-55, 1 minute left to play here in the third. Three-point attempt, this time off the front of the iron. Whoa! Ball's going to stay on that end, Bowman Academy. C.J. McCarter had the positioning. Over his back was Justin King. They said the ball was knocked out of bounds by number 44 for the Knights. Inbounds pass by number 33, Bearfield. Devon Dillard in the air, bucket's good, heading the line. Point add for Bowman. Bowman Academy once again, the sixth year of its program. Free throws up and in. BJ picks it out of the air. Looking for James Shelton, intercepted it. James had a look too from beyond the arc there for a second. Because James can stop and pop on a dime. Foul's going to be called on Haggard the third. James to head of the line for the front end of the 1-1. So Devon Dillard, five monster jams in this game, and an emphatic monster jam by James Blackman. JBJ throwing it down big time. I've never seen him dunk it like that before. I think he just took his game to another level tonight. Sure, the score is 76-57, but Bowman goes deep on the bench. And Luers, these guys are still looking to play, learning to play with each other. Cameron LaShore, a starter for him, he's out with injury. Speculation there, he's sat out the last two games. We saw him against Northrop. And Cameron LaShore, three-pointer is good by Deshaun Lanier. Cameron LaShore is actually a guy who can match this speed. He is one of the faster point guards I've seen in the SAC. Right up there with Leander Williams from Snyder. Yeah, actually, I think LaShore is probably the fastest basketball player in the city so far. Cameron LaShore, 5'8" junior guard, number five. C.J. McCarter at the line for two. Banks open. Eight seconds left here in the third, 78-58. Off the heel, rebounded by Lanier. All the way on the other end, 3-point. That one's off the heel as well. James looked up, did not have enough time to get that shot off, conserving his energy as he needs it. He's almost playing for two players right now. So, after three, 78-58, James Blackman Jr. Eleven points in the quarter. 26 on the night. Devon Dillard. He had 8 points in the quarter, so he has 24 on the night. 26 on the night. So James Blackman Jr. and Devon Dillard tied with a game-high 26 points apiece. Both teams in the bonus as we start the fourth here. Thank you. inbounds by Terrell Johnson, looking for C.J. McCarter, knocked away by Eagles. Suffocating defense. V.J. picked that one up, now driving the lane, looking for the lane. Nice block, put back by C.J. McCarter, is no good. With the block was number 22, Justin King, for the Eagles. King, once again, 6'7" forward. Iowa, Northern Illinois, DePaul, and Valparaiso all looking at the big man. CJ drops it. CJ in the first half had 7 points. He's got 11 in the game. Rebound by Devon. Devon Dillard, 6'4" sophomore. From the corner, nice feed to King. King off the glass. James Blackman looking for the travel. Coach, that is. James looking to drive. There's three Eagles around him. BJ picking up that ball before the backcourt violation. That one went off Dillard's knee. Nothing you can do. Just guys all over the place. Dillard gets it back. James comes up with the loose ball. Luers has numbers here. James looks like he was heading to the left, opted to go to the right at the last moment, lost his balance there. Seven minutes now left in the fourth. Lob up to Devon Dillard. Sixth dunk of the game. Pulled down by number 33. Dillard with a lob this time of Justin King. King trying to go off the glass a little bit too hard as James comes down with it. Blackburn off the glass. Getting her done. 82-61. Number 33, Montrell Barfield. Travel called on number 11, Lyndon Jackson. There's one thing you could point to, maybe a flaw, Bowman Academy. Well, a couple traveling's been called on him. But hard to point out really any flaws with this team. I'm very impressed with how hard they go, and we're already in the fourth quarter. This is how it's been all game if you're just joining us. With the steal, Jackson off the back of the iron. C.J. McCarter did not come down with that ball. Three-point attempt this time. Jackson hits it off the back of the iron. Big three-pointer, Lyndon Jackson. B.J. looking to answer from the wing. Rattled out. B.J. now with the steal. Feed goes to James. He's going to be fouled on the way up. Foul's going to go on number 35, Deshaun Lanier. James at the line to shoot two. And he's good at the free throw line. There's no doubt about that. James with last 3 points for Bishop Luers. Up and in. 85-63. Justin King off his hands, turnover by Bowman Academy. We got team in attendance here. Scout the Knights. James Blackman looking to split defenders. Foul's going to be called on, I believe, number 2, Haggard the third. No, it goes on number 33, Montrell Barefoot. That's his first, team's 10. James Blackman shooting two more here. Got it. Check out James on the day. Once again, perfect from the free throw line. Man, Tom Crean's got to like that. Obviously he does. So back to a 20-point add for Bowman Academy. King, baseline drive, 22. '87-'65 now, inside 5 minutes to play. Shelton looking for CJ right through his legs. PJ. It's like Austin Rubicki check back in for the Knights. Called on Lyndon Jackson. BJ's at the line. Shoot two. Off the front of the iron. Egypt. Elbow jumper. Ball's knocked around. Vicky going after it. Tyrell Johnson picks up the loose ball. VJ looking at the three for a second. Beautiful lay-in by Skywalker. '87-'68 inside 4 minutes to play now. Dunk attempt there by Mr. King, and he was fouled hard going to the line. King's first, off the mark, no good. Second one, no good as well. Well, big. Shelton was underneath the bucket. Popping right back up is number 35, Deshaun Lanier. That was a big dunk, and he'll head to the line looking for the and one. Folks, I saw that one time at Dorsey High School in Los Angeles where young man in transition went up for a dunk two-handed. His feet swung out and so much force went into that dunk. His hand slipped and he landed on the back of his neck. He was okay in that game and on that dunk attempt, but wow, what a scare for everybody in attendance over there at Dorsey High School. James Blackman going the other way with it. James finishing. Fancy work there by Mr. Blackman. 89-70. James really rising to the occasion in this game. That dunk we saw earlier in the third. Wow. Tyrell Johnson. I mean, really, this whole Luers team has really just kind of picked up the tempo. Folks, I'm going to attempt to go down and get an interview for you. at the conclusion of this game. Jumper, 18, 17 footer, no good. Stepping on the line was number 10, Sean Franklin. Three minutes left to play here in the fourth. 89-70. Folks here at Bishop Luers tonight, seems more like it would be July and we're covering an AAU championship. This is the pace of this game and the star power on the court. Tyrell Johnson at the line. Foul was called on number 3. Anthony George, a sophomore. Anthony is a 5'4" guard. Johnson misses the first. Second one's good, so. 89-71. Timeout called. James Blackman Sr. .55 left on the clock here in the fourth, 89-71. The inbounds pass will be number 35, Lanier. Luers came out there in the press. This is one of those games that's only going to make Luers a better team. There's no doubt. Not sure I'd like to be their next SAC opponent. Let me check it out for you, too. Next on the slate here, Fort Wayne Snyder. Actually, that'll be a really neat matchup there with Leander Williams and Aaron Washington, Devin Williams. Snyder coming off the victory at Dwenger. Rebounded there by Dillard. James Blackman now over to BJ. BJ looking to throw it down. James looking for the putback. Gets his own rebound and gets the putback. 89-73, Luers now with the last 6 points. Luers, Devon Dillard. Bowman Academy now kind of going in a half-court set here. And before that, you blink your eye and they were down on the other end. Going hard to the hole, Lanier for two. Pulled off the press as well, so 91-73. Johnson, BJ, James in the corner. They're still playing tight defense on James. James, one of the leading scorers in this game, if not the leading scorer. Devon Dillard's right up there with him. Lanier, an easy two. I'll tell you what, you have to be a well-conditioned team to keep up with Bowman Academy. James Blackman Jr. for three. believe that is Solomon Smith. I don't know if he got an ankle sprain. Or no, it looks like some cramping. Nice to see it's not a rolled ankle. This can be tough to come back from. 51 seconds left, and looks like they're going to carry. No, that's Tyrell Johnson. Johnson's going to walk it off. A little cramp. He's all right. Tyrell really playing a good game here. Austin Mack about to go back in for Johnson. Johnson really just doing a good job of getting the ball up the court, breaking press. I mean, that in itself almost seems like it should be worth a couple points in this game. Looks we're inside a minute, 45 seconds left on the clock, 93-76. VJ with the turnover. King. That's going to go to Luers. Check. Check one. Put back. Big time dunk there for Tony Shelton.
Tony Shelton coming up big for Luers. Folks, we got 4 seconds left on the clock here. I'm going to head down. Scores 93-78. That's Justin King at the free throw line. Second one's no good. Rebounded by James Blackman. Blackman's going to pull up for three, hard off the glass. So that'll do it. Your final, 94-78. Bowman Academy with the victory here. Impressive win. We'll see if we can't pick up an interview with Mr. Devon Dillard here at the conclusion. One of the larger leads of the game here. Lead was upwards to 22, 24 points. Devon, a great game by you and your team here. Constant pressure on the Bishop Luers Knights. You guys entered with a 7-7 record. Just kind of talk about the start of the season. I was a little bit very impressed to see a 7-loss team play this way.
Yeah, we just started the season. It was a new team getting put together, so we just wanted to find how to play with each other. And after these couple games, we took a couple losses that we knew we could have won. So we just bonded together, and we got these wins off playing together. And that's the only way we're going to win. That's the only way we're going to get back down to state.
You know, last year, absolutely losing to Park Tudor with Yogi Ferrell and Trayvon Blewett over there. But you guys feel like this is a team that can get back to the state championship game?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And I already know we're going to end up playing them again. So we just got to come and play with the same intention that we came down with tonight. And we're going to end up facing this team again. I kind of feel it.
Absolutely. Now let's talk about the recruiting process here. I got a chance to speak with your athletic director earlier today. He said North Carolina, IU, Purdue, Michigan State. What's that process been like for you?
I didn't want to get too caught up in the scouts. I just wanted to play my game. I just wanted to stay focused, stay humble, and more scouts to come. I'm only a sophomore, and I know I don't want to get caught up in all that. Yeah, I got plenty of time. But it's good knowing that schools watch me. It's just letting me know that the effort I'm putting into the game is working.
Well, it was a wonderful game by you and your team. Congratulations on the big win. That's going to do it here from Bishop Luers. Once again, a big victory for Bowman Academy, 94-78. Thanks for tuning in.